Hasbro Go Go Goes with new Power Rangers toys. Here's your look at the new Hasbro Power Rangers Lightning Collection Zeo Green Ranger. Using the power of the rectangular subcrystal, Adam becomes the Zeo 4 Green Ranger. The Zeo Green Ranger toy includes multiple character-inspired accessories and swappable heads, one of the Ranger in his helmet and one without. Before we get down to the review of the Zeo 4 Green Ranger, the first thing we're going to want to do is figure out how tall the figure stands. While I'm doing this, I'd like to thank as well the folks who were at Hasbro that provided the sample of the Zeo Green Ranger that we could have a look at in this review. Taking the tape measure to this helmeted head sculpt, he comes with two after all, I'm going to stop it right there. According to the readouts, the Zeo Green Ranger stands 6.240 inches. Probably didn't need to throw that all in there. 6.2 inches probably sounds a little bit better. We're going to switch that over to centimeters, revealing that the figure stands 15.8 centimeters tall. What I like about these Lightning Collection Power Rangers figures is that they're stacked with accessories. Let's have a look at those right now. Starting perhaps maybe with the smallest, and by smallest I don't necessarily mean that it's not the coolest, comes included with this Zeo laser pistol. It's got some neat detailing done to it. I'm assuming it probably was molded initially, either in white or the clear that you can see on the end peg there. And then they've very intricately gone in there and painted the additional gold, the black on the handle on the top there as well, and the red that's located on the back there as well. Now this does either fit into his hands, or it can also be side holstered on the side of his belt, which I'll show you guys right now. Just move his arm up. He actually has two compartment slots. One on this side will be specifically for his power pod sword, and this side right here will be for his laser pistol. You slide that right in, conveniently tucked to the side, and it's on the ready if he actually then needs it. We're going to go ahead and pull it back out, though. I know it seems a bit strange that I took the time to pocket that, only to pull it back out. We're going to put that just to the side for the time being. I had already mentioned that he also comes included with his power pod sword. Now, the Neo Zeo power pod sword, as you can see again, has been molded in this case, probably in more of a silver plastic. Then, as you can see, the hilt has been painted quite exquisitely with the gold and the additional blue. Now, while I draw the attention to these particular accessories, because he also comes included with an effect. The effect is generally quite soft. It's a very soft, rubbery plastic, but there's a hole on the end of it. You can either do one of two things. You can either attach it to the power pod sword by simply just attaching it, just taking the very end of the sword and just plugging it into the hole like that. You can either have it like this, or what you can also do too, pull that right off, go back and retrieve the laser pistol, and we'll go ahead and see that. Remember that little clear peg that was on the end? That just fits right onto the blast effect, that firing effect. And that looks super cool. So I like that. But you can go ahead, like I said, you can take the pistol. We'll go back and put it back in his holsters for the time being, slide that into the one side, and then while we're at it, we can go ahead and move his arm up, then go ahead, reach off to the side and grab his power pod sword and slide that also down into the holster located on the side. You just will want to be careful because his arms and the length of the sword, but slide that right down like that. So there's nice convenient storage they can have displayed. If you say, for example, don't want to display either one of the accessories with the Power Ranger. The last thing he also comes included with, actually, that's not necessarily 100% true. He comes also with some swappable hands, and he also comes with a swappable head portrait of Adam. But the other accessories he comes included with are the Zeo 4 power axes. I do really like these. I think of all the things I would likely display, I think, with the Green Ranger, the axes would be number one for me. Got some nice silver done to the handle, the blades as well. And again, like matching his outfits, you got some nice green with some additional gold accented not only on the handles, but also along the top areas there as well. Really like the look of these. I did mention that he does come included with a couple of hands. The rather interesting thing about it, though, is all the cool accessories I just finished listing off to you. I mean, I don't know why you'd necessarily want to display him with closed fists. I mean, he does come with that option available, but I would necessarily just completely pass on the idea of displaying him with closed fists because, like I said, those accessories are just way too cool not to be displayed in either one of his hands. So, like I said, he does come with those as well. But let's go ahead and just put the axes into his hand. One of his hands actually, not both of his hands, because this hand actually is just more set up to grab onto something. But this one specifically seems to be set up with a trigger firing hand suitable for holding the pistol. But for the time being, I'm actually just going to take the axes and slide them into his hands. The hands are a soft enough plastic, at least, that the fingers move away from the palm. You can do the exact same thing on the other side as well. If you do find it's too tight, then you can obviously just go in there and reach for the fingers, pull them away from the palm, just enough to kind of get your axe handle in there. Whoops, and not certainly drop the figure in the meantime. Let's go ahead and just pick that back up. So sorry about that. Let's go ahead and just put the axe, like I said, into his hand. There we go. Navigate, navigate, navigate. And you've got yourself the axes in his hand. Like I said, certainly when it comes to displaying Power Rangers, I'm more inclined to probably display them with their unique weapons rather than the things that they always seem to come with, like their pistol rifles, for example, little pistols. But anyways, he does come included with, like I said, those. He does also come included with the closed fists if you do want to display the figure with that instead. The last thing he comes included with, I'm so thrilled for the fact that they actually include these, are swappable unhelmeted head sculpts. Here we have the unhelmeted head sculpt here of Adam. I do think they did a really good job on the detailing on the face, especially the areas around the eyes. The coloring, I feel, is just the right coloring. And again, like the coloring, that the detailing they did around the eyes is top notch. Even the sculpted hair is quite nice on this as well. To pop the helmeted head sculpt off, mindful of those axes, after all, we're just going to move those aside for the time being. We're going to go ahead and grab the head, wiggle it off the ball joint. You don't have to necessarily make that noise when you're doing that. And then you can go ahead and pop Adam's head sculpt on instead. The ball joint is pretty large, though. So while you are moving it, it may shift around on you. One thing I've said in the past you can always do is bring the ball joint to the furthest back point that you can, and then pop the head sculpt on this way. This will guarantee you that at least the ball joint is going to be moving around on you. And then when you've got that right enough in a good enough place, then you can twist that head sculpt on. There you go. Some may be more inclined, I feel, to probably display their Power Rangers with the helmets. It's just a matter of preference more than anything else. But I like the idea, again, that when it comes to these Lightning Collection figures, you do get the option. You get both available. Seeing as we've already spent some time talking about this one, what I will do is actually just pop this one off the ball joint and retrieve the original head sculpt. Because like I said, probably most people will be most likely displaying their Power Rangers with the helmet. And while we're maybe doing that, I'm going to go ahead and remove the axes as well. I'm going to remove the sword because I don't want that to be bent in place. And I guess maybe, you know what, we'll go ahead and remove the pistol as well. Let's just put all the accessories to the side for the time being. Now let's finally get a closer look at the ZO4 Green Ranger. Detailing on this one is quite good. I actually really have always been a big fan of the green Power Rangers, just because I think like the gold, especially usually the gold that they incorporate with these costumes, works really well with the green. Getting a closer look at the helmeted head sculpt here, for example, you got the nice band of black across the front where the visor is obviously going to be, silver banding outlining on that. And of course, you've got the little indication of the mouth there as well. Paint is really clean on this, and you can see the way that they've divided the helmet. It actually looks like you'd be able to open the back of the helmet up, even though you technically can't. Of course, the collared area here is done in white. For the most part, pretty clean. There are a few little questionable areas right here, where you've got a little green showing up underneath that, unfortunately, where the white maybe hasn't completely finished off that seam line. I do like the gold, though. The detailing done to the front of the collar is really nice, both up the top here and the area that runs just around the front of the chest area. You've got some nice additional sculpting that they did add to that. This particular figure also does have the shoulder crunch, something which we'll talk about more when we get into the articulation of the figure. The one thing I do like about it is that they did factor in that you're going to be moving this as a collector. So you have a finished collar piece right here. But even if you bring the arms out as well, they finish this as well. So it doesn't have an area where all of a sudden the gold paint stops and then you're just left with the green underneath it. No, they actually took the time and painted it all the way through. So no matter how you are moving the arm back and forth, you're still going to be getting the presence of that gold. That's a nice touch. Gold, gold everywhere. You got the gold on the tops of the arms there, leading then onto his white sleeves. Gold then done to his belt. Of course, the holsters on the sides, both also done in gold. Just bring those up there so you can see a closer detail on that. This gold looks super rich on this. It looks like they really did a great job painting this also as well. I don't see any gold bleed anywhere, nor do I see any additional coloring, like the molding of the plastic. I don't suspect this is molded gold plastic. If it was, they probably then painted over top of it anyways, because I don't think you'd be able to get this rich of a metallic gold by just molding the plastic. A little bit further down the legs again, you got the carried traits of the white boots, the band on the top, also done in gold there as well. And it's not just simply painting the gold. There's a lot of additional sculpting going on there as well. Really like how that looks. Now, with these particular figures, if you are interested, the figures do have peg holes on the undersides of their feet. So if you do, for example, want to get Zio the Green Ranger, or Adam, just in a nice pose, you can actually get them in a running pose, for example, or just in a, you know, some sort of cool Power Rangers pose, probably a little bit cooler than I could come up with right now for the time being, but at least there's available peg holes on the undersides of his feet to be able to pull off such feet. Such feet. I see what I did there. For the figure's articulation, his head rotates all the way around, whatever head you decide to go with. The head moves up, the head moves down, and yeah, I guess to some extent you can also rock the head back and forth, just a little bit. As for the arms rotate all the way around. I love the fact that these are superposable. And of course, we already talked about this before, he does have the shoulder crunch as a separate standalone articulation point. And again, I love the fact that they took the time to finish the gold. So no matter how you are moving the arms, the gold is still present. He does have a swivel at the bicep. You can double hinge on the elbow. There's the one, there's the two right there. You can also rotate the hands all the way around. Now the wrist area, well, this part of his forearm isn't something you can swivel. Even though it almost seems to be the case where it looks like you'd be able to rotate it independently, you can't. As for the gloves rotate certainly all the way around. You hinge those also back and forth depending on what hands you decide to go with. Up for his upper torso. Upper torso ball joint. I do love the fact he's got this lower torso crunch. It's a little harder to kind of get things moving simply just because he's got the belt running across it. But I do appreciate the fact that they actually did incorporate a shoulder crunch or a torso crunch. Gives you a little bit of extra posable options available for the figure. And again, you just bring that back. It's got a little snapping click. I'm a little worrisome about doing that because you never really want to hear a figure snap and click. But this is a positive point, at least something that you can actually move on the figure itself. Then for the legs split out. Not quite a full split on the Green Ranger. You can move the legs forward and back. Swivel 3/4 of the way up the thigh. Rotate that all the way around. Got a double hinge on the knee. For the boot is a separate piece. Did I just call it boot? The boots does swivel back and forth. The feet move up and down. And yes, there is also ankle pivot going on as well. Things I like about this figure certainly are the green color. Green Ranger has always been one of my personal favorites. I also like the fact that this one does have a whole lot of accessories to choose from. So not only do you have the option of just displaying it with the axes, but he also has the regular Zio Ranger fare available that you can also display with the figure. And again, because he does have peg holes in the undersides of his feet, if you do want to put this figure in a little more creative of a pose, even though unfortunately Hasbro didn't come include with a display stand certainly for these figure releases, if you have another display stand at your disposal, why not make use of it? And then you could put the Zio Green Ranger in a much more cooler looking pose than what I've currently got going with right now. Of course, one of the cool features about the Lightning Collection Power Rangers is the fact that they also possess the swappable head sculpt, which means if you want to display all your Power Rangers without the helmets, you can pull it off, and it does look pretty effective. It looks like they're actually holding their own helmets and not just a severed head of an action figure. Now, of course, when it comes to holding it in his hand, it's not the easiest thing to do. The hands really aren't designed to be sticking inside the socket joints of the helmet. So instead, what I ended up doing was I just pried the fingers away from the palm just enough to kind of hold the lip of the helmet. And it seems to be stable enough that at least the helmet isn't going to fall out of his hands. Speaking of his hands, there's certainly a lot of things you can put into his hands with the amount of accessories that Hasbro pack with these Power Rangers. I mean, even just with the Zio Green Ranger, he has the Power Pod Sword, the Power Axes, and the Laser Pistol, not to mention a blast effect that you can either attach to the sword or to the pistol. Like I said, there's a lot of customization for exactly how you want to display these Power Rangers on your display shelf. A big thank you again to the folks over at Hasbro that kindly provided this sample that we had a look at, the Lightning Collection Power Rangers Zio Green Ranger, or Zio 4 Green Ranger. What do you guys think of this figure? Let me know down below in the comments section. And if you are a big fan of Power Rangers, certainly make sure you're keeping your peepers peeled to this channel, because the Zio Green Ranger isn't the last of what we're going to be looking at for Power Rangers. There's going to be a whole ton of Power Rangers reviews lined up and coming your way. And as always, guys, thanks for watching. See you guys next time.